My name is Matthias Leisegang. I work at the Charité University Medicine in Berlin. And I'm employed at the Institute of Immunology. Yeah, we work in the field of adoptive T cell therapy, which is using the patient's own T cells to fight cancer. And we are particularly interested in modifying the peripheral T cells of a patient by engineering them with specific receptors, T cell receptors that can recognize antigens that are expressed by the tumor cells. And we focus on antigens that arise from mutations that are found in the cancer cells, which makes this kind of therapy quite specific because only the tumor cells are recognized and no other normal tissue of the patient. So avidity measurements means that you get an idea about how sensitive a T cell is. And in the kind of research that we do, pretty much everything or most of it depends on the T cell receptor that we transfer into the T cell. This T cell receptor has a certain affinity for the antigen that it's recognizing. And the sum of the affinity by the different TCRs expressed on the surface of the T cell gives the avidity of the T cell. And in the end, this determines how sensitive the T cell is. And depending on this, low amounts of antigen can be recognized. And this can be really important because in some clinical trials, it has already been observed that tumor cells can escape the therapy if they express only low amounts of antigen. It is important to have T cells that can recognize low amounts of antigen. And then there's also a second factor, meaning that antigen can be transferred to cells of the stroma. So these are the normal cells that are also in the tumor. And destruction of the stroma has been shown to be very important to eliminate a cancer, so to eradicate it completely. And after transfer of antigen to the stroma, the antigen amount is of course even lower. And it is important that T cells have an affinity or an avidity high enough to be able to recognize such cross-presented antigen on the stroma. I mean, the ZMovie device allows to get information on how strong the binding between two partners actually is. And acoustic force measurements allow for the first time to make an exact determination of the force that is necessary to separate two cell partners, which would in the end allow, for example, to introduce a new parameter in the characterization of T cells. It's unique in the way of the measurements that you can do. So there is no other instrument allowing this kind of measurement. We started out in March last year, people from Lumix came to our lab, and then we first did experiments together. Some initial experiments that showed us that there is potential. And then there was a second phase of collaboration where we were allowed to use the device for a total of 2 months. This allowed us to do also experiments on our own, and the time frame was long enough to get first results, which hopefully will be part of a publication at some point.